Pete Chapman, one vote. Geelong, Jay Kelly, two votes. Geelong, D. Menzel, three votes. I declare the winner of the 2011 Brownlow Medal, Dame Swan from the Collingwood Football Club.
Pleasure to welcome back to the stage the Chairman of the AFL Commission, Mr. Mike Fitzpatrick. Mike.
Dane Swan from Collingwood. At 34 votes, that's the highest number of votes in the 3-2-1 system, so congratulations. Fantastic effort. Dane's 27 years old, from Westmeadows Football Club and Calder Cannons. Made his debut in 2003. He's played 173 games for Collingwood. It's his third time All-Australian this year, named as half-forward in the side. He's the son of multiple Liston Trophy winner Bill Swan. He's Collingwood's first winner since Nathan Buckley, tied for the medal in 2003, and is seeking to play in back-to-back premierships this weekend. I'd like to ask Chris Judd of Carlton to present the medal. I'm happy to do that. Ladies and gentlemen, please charge your glasses. Be upstanding and toast the 2011 Brownlow medalist, Dane Swan.
Thank you, Mike. Dane, congratulations. Remarkable. Well, we don't need these tonight, do we?
I'll save them for Saturday night.
Good on you. A busy week just got a bit busier for you, I think, Dane.
Yeah, no doubt, mate. Certainly didn't come with any intentions of winning, but somehow managed to pull it off, and now I suppose I'll be a bit busy tonight and tomorrow morning, but you know, hopefully that doesn't take the focus off Saturday either.
Dane, you were a favourite last year, and I'm not sure if you relished being a favourite for the Brownlow medal with all that attention, and tonight you felt a little bit more relaxed coming here?
Yeah, well, clearly being the favourite doesn't help last year and tonight, so, but, you know, last year it took a little bit out of me. It was a bit draining with all the external pressure, but like I said, tonight it's come along, hopefully enjoyed, and, you know, the Pendles and Juddy were going to go close, but somehow I've managed to pinch a few votes off them, and, you know, here I stand.
Go back to last Friday night for a moment. I mean, was there a time during that second half you thought, gee, we mightn't get to the big granny?
Yeah, there's no doubt, mate. And I think it's been said when Buddy kicked that goal, you know, he kicks goals a lot all the time. But to do that against us, we, you know, thoughts are going through me as well. It's just not our time. But somehow we found a way to win. We know we didn't deserve to win, but we found a way. And, you know, we're there next Saturday.
Dane, there were some amazing reactions after the match. I mean, on the field, I mean, I think Nick was quoted as saying, you know, it's probably the greatest win of this group almost, you know, better than the grand final in some ways. But the reaction of your president, Eddie, and also particularly your coach, Michael Moldau, so they were amazing scenes, weren't they?
Yeah, they were awesome. You know, I seen the footage of Mick, and I think that just shows how much he cares about the playing group and how much he, you know, he loves coaching us. And, you know, we all felt that way. And, you know, it's just, we didn't deserve to win. And, you know, how we got back and won it, it's just everyone was pumped and super excited. But then, you know, that excitement goes away pretty quickly because, you know, the job's not done. And we face a tremendous Geelong side this Saturday, and we're going to have to be at our best, which we haven't been for a while, to beat them.
Well, you've got a great coach in waiting, a fellow Brownlow medalist, I can say now, Nathan Buckley. But what about Mick this week? I mean, I know that, you know, a grand final overcomes all other things, but it is his last week. I mean, do you feel that there'll be even a slightly different vibe at the club? I mean, because you have talked about your affection for him and what he's meant to you guys.
Yeah, I don't think there'll be a different vibe at the club. I think, you know, everything will be solely focused on winning the grand final. But, you know, in the back of our heads, you know, to do it for Mick, who won't be coaching again. He said he'll never coach again. And to send him out on such a fantastic note would be amazing. And, you know, it's the only AFL coach I've ever had, and he's moulded me into the player I am today. So, you know, whether you like the way I play or you don't, you've got him to thank for it. So, you know, he's been awesome for my career, and, you know, it'll be sad to see him go. But like we said, we've got a new chapter in Nathan, who's going to be just as good for us, and hopefully he can take us just as far.
Tell us a bit about your parents. Dee, your mum, is it Dee? Yeah. I think you banned her a couple of years ago from talking about the Brownlow when you were a cap, when you were the favourite.
Mum loves it. Mum loves the fashion more than the football side. She wouldn't know if I had a kick all year, but you know, Dad's more into it, and I certainly need to get my jeans from my mum. She can't play sport to save herself, but Dad's the one. But they've both been fantastic to support me ever since I was a kid, and, you know, Mum and Dad both, you know, come watch me play and travel to watch me play and did everything humanly possible for me, so, you know, I owe them a great deal.
I used to call the VFA with Eddie in the old days, and it shows you how old I'm getting, Eddie, not you, but your dad was playing. I mean, the two teams that he played for played in the grand final yesterday,
yeah,
didn't
absolutely.
They?
I think he went along, and I'm not exactly sure what he was going for, but, yeah, he played for both of them.
Taylor, who looks gorgeous tonight, I mean, where did you guys meet?
We met in a bar, actually, funnily enough. Unlike me, but, yeah, she was actually visiting out from the States, and just happened to run into her in a bar and couldn't get rid of her. Now she's here 4 years later. Yeah,
she is. So she's been a hard tag, has she?
Yeah, it's the hardest one I've had. So, yeah, but it's been fantastic, yeah. It's been great.
Well, she looks beautiful at the end of the night, doesn't she?
She always does.
She's a good support?
Yeah, no, she's good. Yeah, she's lovely. She doesn't know a hell of a lot about footy, but comes along when she wants and just is there to support me, whether I play bad or play well. It's been great.
Speaking of America, I've got to ask you about Arizona. I mean, you guys went as a collective group, and I know you use the Altitude Room a lot, Dane, at the club. But were you reluctant? Just tell us, and what happened over there?
I'm going to go back next year. That's a certainty, middle of the year now. What happened over there? Well, yeah, I was a bit reluctant to go at first because, you know, we're paid to play footy, and I hate missing games. But they just thought it'd be best for me. They thought, you know, David Butterfin and Mick, who we have the utmost faith in, we regard Butters as, you know, the best sports science guy in the world, and he sort of promised me that I'd get the benefits in the last half of the year. So, and then my body was a little bit sore, but you know, I was still playing, so I had no excuses for the way I was going. But I decided that that would be the best thing for me, so I went over there, and, you know, we didn't train 10 hours a day. We trained pretty much like a normal schedule in the morning, then weights in the arvo, then maybe a little bit of conditioning at night. But we had a little bit of spare time to get some sun in our back, but it was just a great time to freshen up and get away from the fishbowl that's Melbourne and not have to worry too much about footy and just go over there with three other guys and just train pretty hard and just get away. And I freshened up really well, and I've felt great ever since I've been back.
Do you know, Dane, you polled in 9 of the next 10 games when you came back?
No, I didn't. Thanks for that. It was great.
You know I like a stat.
Absolutely.
Mick tonight talked about Andrew Cracker. And Leon's here tonight too. Leon Davis, Chris Tarrant. They're three guys that I think of that weren't in the premiership team last year. You know, Leon's had a remarkable year, All-Australian this year. Crack, we know. I just want to ask you about Chris Tarrant a bit. Were you in his bridal party?
Yeah, got in there.
Tell us about Chris.
Obviously, I come to the footy club when Taz was a key forward, and, you know, we became pretty close, and, you know, he was a star then, and he just kind of lost his way a little bit, and just fell out of form. And I think the best thing for the footy club and him was for him to go play his footy somewhere else. And I think he even said, you know, they've asked him, you know, he's disappointed that he wasn't here for the flag last year, and I think he kind of said, well, he wouldn't have been still playing footy if he had been at Collingwood. And, you know, I still kept in close contact with him when he was in Perth. And for him, for the way he changed his life around and the way he changed his footy around, went down back and, you know, used to be a glamour boy up forward. Now he's just, all he does is spoil down back. He's been an awesome effort, and I am one of his best mates. And, you know, I'd love for him to get that same feeling that I had last grand final day. I'd love to get it for him this Saturday.
I know that, you know, his dad's been struggling. Absolutely. You know, it's been a battle for him, hasn't it?
Yeah, no doubt. You know, he's been... You know, not that he'd let it show. He's been, you know, fantastic at the footy club, and, you know, when he's had time away, he's certainly got back there, and he's made the most of the time he's got with his dad. And it's one of the sides you probably don't know about Chris, how caring he is and how much how family orientated he is. And he, you know, he's been going through a very tough time, and you probably can't understand how tough he's been going. But you know, I think he was awesome on Buddy on Friday night, and for him to keep his sort of mental strength and play the way he's been playing, it's been fantastic for him.
One of your coaches has told me this year, Dane, that you love playing against the Hawks, you love playing against the Saints, and you love playing against the Cats. You don't mind standing lingy. I mean, is that something that you do thrive on, that challenge of it? And I'm thinking, you know, Jones is a great tagger, and you get a tough guy from Hawthorn, obviously, but Ling has been somebody that we've associated with you a bit, haven't we?
Yeah, no doubt. And, you know, I'm sure we'll line up against each other on Saturday, and we've had some good battles. He's won a few, and, you know, I've been lucky to win a few, but... I suppose that all goes out the window now. Hopefully I can overshadow him this Saturday. But, you know, you love playing against the best sides and pitting yourself against the best opposition. And I think everyone knows Cameron Ling's probably the best tagger in the game. And, you know, hopefully, you know, I get a couple of kicks Saturday and do my part in a Collingwood win.
Just a couple more. I mean, the last 3 or 4 weeks, it hasn't quite been the stellar Collingwood that you've had this remarkable season. You've broken all the records. Can you put your finger on it?
No, I can't, mate. You know, it's something we certainly tried to rectify, and you know, but like good sides do, we keep winning. You know, we got flogged in round 24, and you know, Geelong were awesome, and we just had no answer for them. But you know, West Coast came out with enormous pressure, and they were amazing, and they finished fourth for a reason. They showed us, and then we know how good Hawthorn are. But a good like good sides do, we find a way to win, and we, you know, we could have went down by Hawthorn, and you know, no one would have probably said much because how good they were, but. You know, we dug deep and found a way, so, you know, here we are.
Can I ask you one ridiculous question?
I love it.
Mick or Eddie, who'd be more likely to get the first tat if you win on Saturday night? Who would you back in?
The first tat, Eddie. Oh, Eddie's more of a chance than Mick, I think.
Yeah. No worries. It's been 75 years since Collingwood won back-to-back premierships. I mean, it could be, and with Michael's final match, it could be one of the greatest days in the history of the most famous football club of them all.
I certainly hope so, mate. You know, to go back to back is an astounding achievement, and only great clubs do it. And if we're lucky enough to do it, you know, we'll go down in the history of the Collingwood Footy Club. So, you know, we're going to give it our best shot. But like I said, we've got an unbelievable Geelong side standing in our way. And, you know, if they'd like to give it to us, we'll take it. But I'm sure that's not going to happen. And so it's going to be a tough day Saturday, but hopefully we can come out on top.
Here's a challenge for Eddie. Told me earlier tonight that the last Collingwood player to win the Brownlow Medal and win the Premiership in the 1 year was Harry Collier in 1930.
I don't know who that is.
No. not a Dane, is there anyone that you would...
We'll give it a go. All right. I certainly didn't prepare anything, so we'll see how we go. If I've forgotten anyone, I certainly apologise. Obviously, to the footy club, start with, for drafting me and then sticking with me for 10 years now. You know, they've been fantastic, and there's not another club I'd rather play for. All the coaching staff, Daddy and the board, for supporting me through all my ups and downs. Walshy, been fantastic. All the sponsors of the footy club, Adidas, Emirates. I'm sure I'll forget a few more, but we'll just package them in there. Freeway 4 for giving me a Ford to drive around in. Thank you very much. What else? That's about it for sponsors, I think. If I've forgotten anyone, I'm sorry. My family and my friends who are there supporting me no matter how I play, and I'm sure Mum and Dad will be, and the rest of the family will be over the moon. Michael Downey texted me today and said if you wouldn't mention him, so there's your mention. My sister, you know, she doesn't come to many games. When she comes, she's in the bar most of the time, but thank you for coming. My lovely girlfriend Taylor, for the last 4 years, ever since you've been here, my footy's gone up, so something must be going right, so thank you very much. Who else can I thank? All the umpires for giving me your vote. Thank you very much. And to all the other players out there, you know, it's great to play against the best in the competition every week, and you know, it happened to be my turn this year, but I'm sure the other guys will get a go in the coming years. That's about it, I think. So if I've forgotten anyone, I'm sorry, and I'll get round to you at some stage. Thank you very much.
Dane, I reckon... just two quick things. between you and Scott Pendlebury, 58 votes. No two players from one club has ever had more than 50 in the 1 year. Scott, it's a great achievement for the two of you. I reckon, mate, when you retire, you can have your own Tonight Show after that.
Why not, eh? On Life After Footy.
Absolutely.
The most votes ever under the 3-2-1 system. I mean, history has been made tonight. We thought about it would be made in another way. Dane, you are such a worthy winner. What a magnificent player you are. You showed that again in the second half on Friday night. Our 2011 Brownlow medalist from Collingwood Football Club, Dane Swan.